so it was, you know, it looked like it was jury-rigged, at least with the four women in the case. We'll continue with the article. Headline, Judge rules Trump friend will be sentenced Thursday, and that's tomorrow, from the Atlanta Journal Constitution. It's really from the Washington Post, written by Rachel Weiner. Motion remains sealed. Okay, Roger Stone's attorneys, his latest motion remains sealed. And defense attorney Seth Ginsburg said in court Tuesday only that, quote, this issue goes to the heart of the case and is such a fundamental issue, unquote. About the four woman. She worked for the Internal Revenue Service, the IRS, and it was released in the media that she, had some anti-Trump kinds of things going on. Okay, now we want to stop. We want to stop right there because the motion remains sealed, and there was at one point at which this federal judge ruled, it's called a gag order. It's called a gag order that the supporters, and even the general news media, but especially the supporters and family and friends of Roger Stone could not comment in his defense. A gag order. A gag order. In essence, so the man could not, even get, support from those to argue his case in the open media. This entire case is a question of freedom of speech. It's a question of freedom of speech. It's a question in the cyber world. What you can get access to. Because Roger Stone, has his networks, his own networks in the cyber world, his own contacts in the cyber world, and he doesn't even have to say who his sources are. Okay, so at any rate, we'll continue with the article. This whole thing has been kept secret. He's been denied key witnesses. He's been denied the opportunity to make his case in public. To make his case and speak to his defense and have others that are not even biased, that are not even his friends and family, comment on the case. All right, we'll continue with the article. The sealed filing came after President Donald Trump suggested that the four women in the case had, quote, significant bias, unquote. Now, this is our current president. He's intervening here, and he's suggesting, okay, prosecutors, okay, and, a lot of people will stop right there. A lot of people are saying, our current president shouldn't intervene in a particular case that's being prosecuted by the Department of Justice, which is under the Attorney General, and the Attorney General is part of the executive branch. It was under our current president, okay. The direction of our current president, okay. They're saying that he doesn't have his freedom of speech, the president of the United States can't comment on it. I don't think so, but anyway. Prosecutors are expected to file a response to the sealed request today. The ruling to continue with sentencing this week came amid intervention in Stone's case by the Trump administration that has roiled the Department of Justice and federal judiciary. Okay, they're using the word roiled. R-O-I-L-E-D. Well, that's an opinion.
Washington Post.
At any rate, even though what is the U.S. Senate saying about it? They confirm the Attorney General, and if there's any complaints about his performance, if there's any complaints about the interference of our current president with the Department of Justice and the Attorney General, the U.S. Senate, it's up to the U.S. Senate that confirm the Attorney General to take up that particular point. We'll continue with the article.
Atlanta Journal,
Cyber this week came amid intervention in a Stone's case. Okay. Trump has repeatedly criticized the prosecutors, judge, and jury in the case. And the president, you know, has the power to pardon. And the president is the executive branch and selected the current attorney general, and he was confirmed by the Senate. So the president has really ought to have the leeway to at least have freedom of speech, even if it comes through Twitter, to criticize the prosecutors, the judge, and the jury in this case. And really,